So here are a few signs that today's video production is not quite as it normally is. I'm never normally wearing a workout shirt. I'm never normally wearing the two watches. When was the last time you saw me wear glasses? The hair's a mess. The headphones aren't normally on. All of these point to being in major dad mode.
Yes. Is it Radio Lily?
This video was meant to come out last weekend and the day after and the day after that, and off and off and off and off and off. It just kept getting put off because time is so limited. But I really want to tell you about all this stuff that's going on. And I put out a post on Instagram. I asked you guys a series of questions. Mac or PC, Final Cut Pro or DaVinci, Pro Tools or Logic. You guys chimed in pretty epically. There were a lot of responses to that and a lot of opinions. Here's the thing. I think there's no or. I don't think there's an either or. And I think there's a really good use case for both in most cases. I'm a recent addition to the PC Windows family with my Steiger Dynamics beast down here, which I've talked a little bit about before with the Plex server and how I'm using that to kind of access all my material, all my audio, all my video from all over the world. Kind of really excited with going to do the new album in Spain next week and knowing that that is literally right here, down here in the rack, and that I can dial it up in my phone anytime when I'm in the studio in Spain. I'm like, oh, I wonder what that specific thing sounded like, or I need to reference something. So that was one of the main things I'm using the PC for. What I've been thinking about more recently is that it is such a beast of a machine, and I guess Windows machines and PCs in general are just that much more customizable and upgradable as you go. They're not like a Mac. You kind of use it for its lifespan and then you're kind of forced to get another one. You can actually adjust the Windows machine and upgrade it and kind of make it better as you go. So what I've been thinking, especially with the making of the documentary that's going along with the new album, is that I'm going to start checking out DaVinci and using that brain down there for a lot of my video editing. I'm putting the story together for this album in film. I also like the fact that DaVinci seems to be for both platforms, so I could technically go back and forth, and when I'm working with other people with my production team who are using Macs and I might be using Windows machine here, it's kind of compatible. So pretty psyched about that. So in terms of Mac or PC, I think both. I think there's a really strong use case for both. I'm using both here. They're both integrated with a simple switcher for my monitors, so they're both running the whole time, and I have access to all of that stuff right here on my desktop. So that's the first question, Mac or PC. I think both. And I think that answer is going to become a bit of a theme throughout this video. It's the whole Logic Pro Tools thing. I know it's a hard question to answer, or even a hard, impossible question to ask, because I know it's not just Logic and Pro Tools. I know there's Ableton, there's Cubase, there's Digital Performer, there are a ton of other things out there that I know a lot of people use very, very effectively for a variety of different things. I'm a Pro Tools and a Logic guy. Generally, Pro Tools for tracking other people's music. You know, every studio I go to basically has Pro Tools in it, and I know if I'm producing an album, I'm going to end up with a Pro Tools session that I have to edit and work on. So definitely I have a Pro Tools rig here. My software of choice at home is Logic. I'm just quicker in it. I think the MIDI integration is way better than anything else I've used, and I guess I've just been using it for almost 20 years or since it came out. So I think I'm just sort of, my brain is grandfathered in to that ecosystem. And I'm fast with it, and programming is a little easier with it for me. Now, with my album, I know we're going to track in Pro Tools next week in Spain, and I'm going to maybe want to do some post-production stuff. Not a lot of stuff, but maybe some post-production stuff. So I will probably import stems into Logic, do some MIDI stuff potentially, and then export that back to Pro Tools before it goes to Juan Pablo to be mixed. By the way, quick plug for that. If you haven't got involved with the pre-sale, and I know so many of you have, huge thank you for that. The support has been really phenomenal, really overwhelming, and motivation is at like an all-time high right now. That's why I'm like dressed like this and making this kind of like overexposed, really quick, down and dirty video, because I'm just excited about the whole thing, and I want to share that with you. I want to share the progress of that with you, and how incredible it's been that so many people have pre-ordered the album, and kind of just now this community is built around that process of leaving Spotify behind, of leaving, like I said before, what we've kind of come to accept as normal. When we come to release music, there's actually some value seeping back into what I'm doing as an artist. And I have you guys, coffee drinkers, bass players, everyone who made took advantage of the pre-sale so far. I have you to thank for that. So massive, massive thanks. If you haven't got in on the pre-sale, the links are below. There are 5 different levels. A few of the higher tier things, there are only a couple of things left because people jumped in there early. But check it out. All the links are below. The last video on my channel is dedicated to that if you want to go and check out more detail of what we're doing next week in Spain. And the podcast, the most recent episodes of the podcast have some, kind of go into some real detail on the whole concept of leaving Spotify behind and taking this new path and this new journey, you know, initially on my own. But thankfully, it's only been a week, so many of you have come with me. That's huge. Thanks again. Let's get on with the video. So Mac or PC, I think it's both. Logic and Pro Tools, unescapable for me to use both. And I said DaVinci or Final Cut. I've been the Final Cut person forever, since the beginning. It's the only thing I've used after iMovie. I got into Final Cut. It's the only thing I've ever used. So I'm pretty psyched to check out DaVinci. I've heard a lot of amazing things about it. I've seen amazing results. I'm in that kind of research mode, as I always am when I go to something new right now. And time will tell. If I can get quick enough on it, then I don't see why I shouldn't be harnessing like the massive power of the Windows machine I have now. So watch this space. I'll give updates, and maybe I'll do a few test videos, some promo shots, like literally in about 10 days time when I get back from the studio, when I have the footage, maybe I'll do some promo stuff in DaVinci and see how it goes. Quick pedal news related to the sessions coming up next week. Because of how I'm running a stereo rig right now, it's a little more complicated than it's ever been in terms of the recording. I'm splitting a lot of my harmonizer stuff into stereo, the reverbs from stereo, delays, modulation. I've got, after the signal splits out of the HX Stomp, down one side I've got a Pladesk Fabricat, and the other side is the Pladesk Backling. So I've got 2 different kinds of kind of granular delay synthesis stuff going on either side to kind of create that really interesting stereo image. So there's all this stuff going on, and when I'm recording that in the studio and I'm using looping and I'm kind of creating ambient loops and soundscapes and stuff like that, when I then go to play bass or a solo or just some other information into that same stereo channel that the loopers are churning away in, it becomes really haphazard in terms of the mixing. So talking with my engineer, Juan Pablo, down in Argentina, we figured we needed to come up with a solution. We didn't really know what it was, but we definitely needed to kind of like split those 2 elements in 2. So not only am I not just having 1 channel like a bass player mono, I'm having stereo. Now I'm splitting it into 2 stereo sides. I've reached out to my Discord and in the Telegram channel. By the way, if you're not in the Telegram channel, join it below. Link in the description. Lots of really great information and kind of discussion, like every kind of daily discussion happening there. Really fun. So I reached out to all the pedal nerds in my various channels. Somebody mentioned Saturn Works. I'm not even going to be able to get this close to the camera, but Saturn Works, really cool little company here in California, and they make a stereo splitter. So I'm going to come out of my last, I think it's a reverb, stereo reverb in here. Then I'm going to split 1 stereo pair into my loopers, and then the other stereo pair is going to go straight to the console. So I'll be able to have all that ambient stuff going on and split it away from the bass playing and the soloing, whatever other content I might want to put into my bass performance in that live recording situation. So watch this space. That is going to be a lot of fun. I doubt I'll ever be able to have 2 stereo rigs live to do that, but in the studio, I think it's going to create an incredible stereo image. One last quick and epic thing before we go. I had a very unexpected and very cool reconnection with a friend and colleague from back in my days with TC Electronic. Kat is now working for Caveman Audio out of Denmark, and I am now the proud owner of the Caveman BP one preamp, basically a Neve 1073 and a pedal. This thing is, it's unbelievable. It's built like a tank as well. It's really heavy. It's not the most portable thing in the world, but that is coming with me to Spain, to the studio. I think it will go up front in my signal. And I only got this yesterday. I'll definitely, of course, post some video of some sound clips with that. But it kind of opened up this pretty ridiculous, like, extra few percent of range in the natural sound of my bass. So I'm really psyched to put my bass through that at the beginning of the chain, especially on some of the more melodic things and perhaps completely solo bass things. There are a couple of things I have in mind to record which are just bass, and I really want to get that amazing clarity and organic sound of the instrument and the fingers and the strings. So BP1 bass preamp by Caveman, freaking psyched that is in the lineup now. And that's it. We could go on the this or that and that or this forever. I'm sure there are like 20 more videos we can make on that, but for now, that's it. That's my Mac or PC, Pro Tools or Logic, Final Cut Pro or DaVinci, this or that answer, plus some nerdy pedal updates and studio updates and project updates. Really, I'm buzzing. This video is probably a little bit garbled as a result because that's what's going on in my brain right now. But better to check in and give you an honest representation of the chaos and mayhem that is like dad duty and husband duty and music duty and all of that kind of stuff. And maybe I'll get back to the kind of more slick and dark and jazz club vibe of my other videos at some point when I have a little bit of time. But that's it. That's the update. Pre-sale for the new album is below, and I'll catch you all in the next video.